1, Focused Listening. Page 2, As You Listen. Part A, Close Your Book. Listen to the conversation between Andrea and Eric to find the answers to these questions. What is Eric worried about? How does Andrea help him?
What's wrong, Eric?
I'm really nervous. I'm always this way on the first day of school.
You're not the only one. It's hard for me, too. I'm glad we're taking this class together.
Do you know anything about the teacher?
Uh-huh, a little. Someone told me she gives a lot of homework, and you have to talk a lot in class.
Oh, no. I'm afraid of talking in front of a lot of people.
Oh, don't worry. Everyone's afraid at the beginning, but after you get to know the people and make friends...
It doesn't get better for me. I'm shy. I have trouble looking at people when I talk, and my hands shake.
Look, the teacher's here. Let's talk after class.
Focused Listening, page 2. As You Listen, part B. Listen again, but this time, read the conversation as you listen.
What's wrong, Eric?
I'm really nervous. I'm always this way on the first day of school.
You're not the only one. It's hard for me, too. I'm glad we're taking this class together.
Do you know anything about the teacher?
Uh-huh, a little. Someone told me she gives a lot of homework, and you have to talk a lot in class.
Oh, no. I'm afraid of talking in front of a lot of people.
Oh, don't worry. Everyone's afraid at the beginning, but after you get to know the people and make friends...
It doesn't get better for me. I'm shy. I have trouble looking at people when I talk, and my hands shake.
Look, the teacher's here. Let's talk after class.
Your turn. Listening Challenge, page 9. Listen to the short conversation. Two people are asking questions because they want to get to know each other. Which question is first? Which question is second? As you hear each question, put a number on the line at the left.
Hi, where are you from?
Japan. How about you?
I'm from Mexico.
When did you come to the U.S.?
Oh, about a month ago. And you?
About 6 months ago.
Do you like it here?
Now I do. But I didn't like it at the beginning.
Why not?
Well, I didn't understand anything. Everyone was speaking very fast.
I know what you mean. You know, I don't know your name.
It's Rika. What's your name?
Jose. It's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
Exercise 1. Mini Dialogues. Page 11. Listen to the mini dialogues. Repeat what you hear. 1.
I'm afraid of talking on the phone in English.
Don't be afraid. You can do it.
It's hard to get to know people when you live in a big city.
I have trouble getting to know people, too.
3.
What's wrong?
I'm afraid of dogs. Can you take him away?
4. I'm sorry, but I can't come. I have a cold.
I hope you get better soon.
5.
At the beginning, I always said, "Sorry, I don't speak English."
But now what do you say?
6.
I don't want to leave. I made a lot of friends here.
Don't worry. You'll see them again. Seven.
He can come with us tonight. He doesn't have to work.
That's great.
Exercise 4. Listen and write the expressions. Page 13.
What's wrong, Andrea?
Now I'm afraid of our class. The teacher said we have to do a lot of homework.
Don't worry. I can help you. I think the class will be good, and we are going to make friends there.
Eric, you're funny. At the beginning, you were afraid, and now you're fine. What happened?
I don't know. I enjoyed talking to the students, and I want to get to know them. Maybe I won't have trouble talking in this class. I wasn't very nervous after the first 5 minutes.
That's great. I can see you're happy that you are taking this class. I think your English will get better very quickly.
I hope you're right.
Exercise 6. Dictation. Page 14. You will hear the dictation 3 times. First, just listen. Second, as you listen, write the dictation on a piece of paper. Skip lines. Third, check what you wrote.
Eric is a student. He is very nervous on the first day of class. He is afraid of talking in front of people. His friend Andy tells him, "Don't worry." She says he will get to know people in the class and make friends. After class, Eric feels better, but Andy is nervous. She is afraid of having a lot of homework. Eric tells Andy that he will help her. Eric is a student, period. He is very nervous on the first day of class, period. He is afraid of talking in front of people, period. His friend Andy tells him, comma, open quote, don't worry, period, closed quote. She says he will get to know people in the class and make friends, period. After class, Eric feels better, comma. But Andy is nervous, period. She is afraid of having a lot of homework, period. Tells Andy that he will help her, period. Eric is a student. He is very nervous on the first day of class. He is afraid of talking in front of people. His friend Andy tells him, "Don't worry. She says he will get to know people in the class and make friends." After class, Eric feels better. But Andy is nervous. She is afraid of having a lot of homework. Eric tells Andy that he will help her.
Lesson 2, page 20. Focused listening. As you listen, part A, close your book. Listen to the conversation between Anna and Alex, and then Alex and Sarah, to find the answers to these questions. Why is Alex calling? Does Sarah want to see Alex?
Hello?
Hi, Sarah.
Who's this?
It's Alex.
Oh, hi, Alex. This is Anna. Hold on a minute, and I'll get Sarah. Sarah, it's for you.
I'll be right there. Alex? Hi.
Hi, Sarah. Want to go to the movies Friday night?
I'm really sorry, but I can't make it Friday night. How about Saturday?
Sure. Why don't I pick you up at 7 o'clock?
That sounds great. Oh, Alex, I'm sorry. My parents are calling me for dinner, and I have to get off. See you Saturday.
Great. See you. Bye.
Focused listening. Page 2. As you listen. Part B. Listen again, but this time, read the conversation as you listen.
Hello?
Hi, Sarah.
Who's this?
It's Alex.
Oh, hi, Alex. This is Anna. Hold on a minute, and I'll get Sarah. Sarah, it's for you.
I'll be right there. Alex? Hi.
Hi, Sarah. Want to go to the movies Friday night?
I'm really sorry, but I can't make it Friday night. How about Saturday?
Sure. Why don't I pick you up at 7 o'clock?
That sounds great. Oh, Alex, I'm sorry. My parents are calling me for dinner, and I have to get off. See you Saturday.
Great. See you. Bye.
Your turn. Listening challenge, page 26. Read the list of suggestions below. Then listen to 6 sentences. After you hear each sentence, give a suggestion from the list. Write the letter of the suggestion next to the number of the sentence that you hear.
1. It's a nice day.
2. We have a test tomorrow.
3. I want to learn how to play the guitar.
4. I'm tired.
5. They're bored.
6. We're hungry.
1. Mini dialogues. Page 28. Listen to the mini dialogues. Repeat what you hear. 1.
Can you come on Sunday?
I'm sorry, but I can't make it.
2.
Bill, it's for you.
I'll be right there.
3.
Why don't I pick you up after school?
Thank you. That's really nice of you.
4.
Sorry. I have to get off. because I need to pick Jim up.
Okay. I'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye.
Five.
Hello. Can I please speak to Anne?
Who is this? Six.
Can you answer the phone?
Sure. I'll get it.
Exercise 4, page 30. Listen and write the expressions.
Hello?
Hi, can I speak to Sarah, please?
Who's this?
This is Alex.
Hold on a second. Sarah, it's for you. It's Alex.
I'll be right there. Hi, Alex.
Hi, Sarah. How are you doing?
Fine. How about you?
Pretty good. I had a really great time last night.
I did too. That's a great restaurant.
I know. Why don't we go back there next weekend?
That sounds great. When?
Is Friday okay? I can pick you up at 7 o'clock again.
Why don't I drive this time? I'll pick you up at 7 o'clock.
That's fine with me. I'll be waiting for you. Take care.
Alex, wait. Don't hang up. There's one more thing. Last week, you paid for dinner. This time, I want to pay.
Sarah, no.
Yes, listen.
Exercise 6. Dictation. Page 31. You will hear the dictation 3 times. First, just listen. Second, as you listen, write the dictation on a piece of paper. Skip lines. Third, check what you wrote.
When Alex calls his friend Sarah, her sister Anna answers the phone. Anna asks, "Who's this?" And Alex says, "It's Alex." Anna tells her sister, "It's for you." And Sarah comes to the phone. Alex invites Sarah to go to the movies on Friday night. Sarah can't make it on Friday, but Saturday is good. But they don't go to the movies. They go to dinner, and it's great. They want to go to the same restaurant again. But Sarah wants to drive there. She also wants to pay. When Alex calls his friend Sarah, comma. Her sister Anna answers the phone, period. Anna asks, comma, open quote, "Who's this?" Question mark, closed quote. And Alex says, comma, open quote, "It's Alex," period, closed quote. Tells her sister, comma, open quote, "It's for you," exclamation point, closed quote. And Sarah comes to the phone, period. Alex invites Sarah to go to the movies on Friday night, period. Sarah can't make it on Friday, comma. But Saturday is good, period. But they don't go to the movies, period. They go to dinner, and it's great, period. They want to go to the same restaurant again, comma. But Sarah wants to drive there, period. She also wants to pay, period. When Alex calls his friend Sarah, her sister Anna answers the phone. Anna asks, "Who's this?" And Alex says, "It's Alex." Anna tells her sister, "It's for you," and Sarah comes to the phone. Alex invites Sarah to go to the movies on Friday night. Sarah can't make it on Friday, but Saturday is good. But they don't go to the movies. They go to dinner, and it's great. They want to go to the same restaurant again. But Sarah wants to drive there. She also wants to pay.
Lesson 3. Focused Listening. Page 40. As You Listen. Part A. Close your book. Listen to the conversation between Peter and Alice to find the answers to these questions. Where are they going to go next month? What season, fall, winter, spring, or summer, is it now?
You know, we have a 3-day weekend next month. Do you want to go away?
That's a great idea. Where do you want to go?
To the beach.
The beach? In the winter?
We don't have to go swimming. We can take walks on the beach.
But what else can we do?
Oh, there are plenty of things to do. We can read, go to the movies. I need to relax, don't you?
I sure do. You're right. The beach is a good idea, and it won't be crowded. Do you think we need to make a reservation anywhere?
No, I don't think so. There are lots of places to stay, and they will be cheaper now than they are in the summer.
Focused Listening, page 40. As You Listen, part B. Listen again, but this time, read the conversation as you listen.
You know, we have a 3-day weekend next month. Do you want to go away?
That's a great idea. Where do you want to go?
To the beach.
The beach? In the winter?
We don't have to go swimming. We can take walks on the beach.
But what else can we do?
Oh, there are plenty of things to do. We can read, go to the movies. I need to relax, don't you?
I sure do. You're right. The beach is a good idea, and it won't be crowded. Do you think we need to make a reservation anywhere?
No, I don't think so. There are lots of places to stay, and they will be cheaper now than they are in the summer.
Your turn. Listening challenge, page 48. Someone is on the phone making a reservation at a restaurant. First, read the four questions. Then, listen. After you listen, answer the questions.
Ruby's Place, may I help you?
Yes, I'd like to make a reservation for two for Saturday night.
What time?
8 o'clock.
Okay, and your name, please?
Healy, H-E-A-L-Y.
Okay, that will be Saturday night at 8 o'clock for two.
Right, and can I reserve a table by the window? It's our wedding anniversary and...
No problem.
Thanks a lot. See you on Saturday.
Bye.
Exercise 1. Mini dialogues. Page 49. Listen to the mini dialogues. Repeat what you hear. 1.
We went shopping and then we went out to lunch.
What else did you do?
Do we need to leave now?
No, we have plenty of time. We can leave in a half hour.
Three.
That restaurant is always crowded. Do you think we need to make a reservation?
That's a good idea. I'll call right now.
Full. Does anyone want to take a walk with me?
Great idea. I'll be right there.
5.
Lots of people want to go away in the summer. That's why it's so crowded everywhere.
Not everywhere. I'm sure we can find a quiet place.
6. You're working too hard. You need to take a vacation.
I know, but I don't have any more vacation days this year.
7.
Where's Sherry?
She's on vacation until next Monday.
4. Listen and write the expressions. Page 51.
Hi, Bonnie. How was your weekend?
Pretty good. I stayed home and relaxed. How about you? Did you and Alice go away?
Uh-huh. We found a small town near the beach and stayed in a nice motel for 3 nights. It was great, and it wasn't expensive.
What did you do at the beach? Wasn't it cold?
Yeah, a little. We didn't go swimming, but we took long walks, and we got plenty of fresh air.
That sounds great. At this time of year, it probably wasn't crowded.
No, it wasn't.
So, what else did you do?
Well, let's see. On Saturday night, we went dancing at a club. And on Sunday, we went ice skating. It was a lot of fun.
It sounds like you had a great weekend. Can you give me the name of the motel? Maybe Ed and I can go there sometime.
Exercise 6. Dictation. Page 52. You will hear the dictation 3 times. First, just listen.
Second, as you listen, write the dictation on a piece of paper. Skip lines. Third, check what you wrote. Alice and Peter go away for the weekend. They go to the beach. It is winter, so they can't go swimming. But they take walks on the beach, and they get plenty of fresh air. On Friday night, they go dancing, and on Sunday, they go ice skating. They have a good time and are very happy. Alice and Peter go away for the weekend, period. They go to the beach, period. So they can't go swimming, period. But they take walks on the beach and they get plenty of fresh air, period. On Friday night, they go dancing, comma. And on Sunday, they go ice skating, period. They have a good time and are very happy, period. Alice and Peter go away for the weekend. They go to the beach. It is winter, so they can't go swimming. But they take walks on the beach and they get plenty of fresh air. On Friday night, they go dancing, and on Sunday, they go ice skating. They have a good time and are very happy. Lesson 4, Focused Listening, page 58. As you listen, part A, close your book. Listen to the conversation between Mike and Tom to find the answers to these questions. Why does Tom need to get up? Why is Tom having trouble getting up?
Wake up, Tom. Don't you have to go to the airport?
Yeah, I'll get up in 5 minutes. I don't want to get out of bed. It's so early.
Well, I'm going back to sleep. I hope you won't miss your plane. Have a good trip.
Thanks. Oh, why did I go to bed so late last night? It's so hard to get up, and it's so cold and dark. But I need to get up now and take a shower. What time is it? 6 o'clock? Oh no, I'm late. I don't have time for a shower. I have to get dressed and get to the airport right away.
Focused Listening, page 58. As you listen, part B. Listen again, but this time read the conversation as you listen.
Wake up, Tom. Don't you have to go to the airport?
Yeah, I'll get up in 5 minutes. I don't want to get out of bed. It's so early.
Well, I'm going back to sleep. I hope you won't miss your plane. Have a good trip.
Thanks. Oh, why did I go to bed so late last night? It's so hard to get up, and it's so cold and dark. But I need to get up now and take a shower. What time is it? 6 o'clock? Oh no, I'm late. I don't have time for a shower. I have to get dressed and get to the airport right away.
Your turn, B. Listening challenge, page 68. This is a dictation. Write the imperative sentences, commands, you hear. End each with an exclamation point.
1. Wake up! You're late!
2. Don't fall asleep again! Get up!
3. Don't go back to sleep. Get out of bed.
4. Get dressed. You're late.
5. Put on a jacket. It's cold.
1. Mini dialogues. Page 68. Listen to the mini dialogues. Repeat what you hear. 1.
Wake up, you're late.
I don't care. It's too cold to get up.
2.
What time did you go to bed last night?
Very late.
3.
Sorry, I don't have time to talk. I have to go to the airport.
Have a great trip.
Dressed.
5.
It's really cold in here.
Why don't you put on a sweater?
6.
It's really hot in here.
Why don't you take off your sweater? 7.
Look at the baby.
Isn't that sweet? She fell asleep.
8.
Why are you so tired today?
Because I stayed up really late last night.
9.
Let's go shopping early tomorrow morning.
I really need to sleep late tomorrow. Can we go around noon?
4. Listen and write the expressions. Page 70.
So, how was your trip?
Great. My cousin's wedding was really nice, and I saw a lot of my friends and relatives.
Did you miss your plane?
You know, I almost did. I was really late because I didn't want to get up, remember?
Yeah, it was really cold and dark in here.
But I went back to sleep on the plane. When I woke up, I felt better. And when I got to my parents' house, it was great. We had time to talk and relax. I put on some of my old clothes and worked in the garden. Then I took a shower and got dressed for the wedding.
What did you wear? Do you have any nice clothes?
Sure I do. I have a suit, you know.
I don't believe it. You need to show me some pictures of you in a suit. I know you only in blue jeans.
Exercise 6. Dictation. Page 71. You will hear the dictation 3 times. First, just listen. Second, as you listen, write the dictation on a piece of paper. Skip lines. Third, check what you wrote.
Tom has to wake up early to go to the airport. But when his roommate wakes him up, he doesn't want to get up. The room is very cold and dark, and he wants to go back to sleep. Tom gets up, but he doesn't have time to take a shower. He gets dressed quickly and goes to the airport. He's lucky because he doesn't miss his plane. Tom has to wake up early to go to the airport. Period. But when his roommate wakes him up, comma. He doesn't want to get up, period. The room is very cold and dark, comma. And he wants to go back to sleep, period. Tom gets up. But he doesn't have time to take a shower, period. He gets dressed quickly and goes to the airport. Period. He's lucky because he doesn't miss his plane. Period. Tom has to wake up early to go to the airport. But when his roommate wakes him up, he doesn't want to get up. The room is very cold and dark, and he wants to go back to sleep. Tom gets up, but he doesn't have time to take a shower. He gets dressed quickly and goes to the airport. He's lucky because he doesn't miss his plane.
Lesson 5. Focused Listening. Page 82. As you listen. Part A. Close your book. Listen to the conversation between the brother and sister to find the answers to these questions. What are they celebrating? Who's going to pay for lunch?
Oh, it's so nice to eat out and have time together. What a great birthday present.
I'm glad you like it. I'm always happy to treat you to lunch. And I was thinking, you know, we never really have time to just sit and talk.
I know. And now we have 2 hours. And this is a really nice place.
Yeah, I come here once in a while.
So, what are you going to have?
I'm not sure yet. But you order whatever you want. It's your birthday.
Whatever I want? Okay. But please, don't sing happy birthday when we have dessert. If you do, I'll go under the table.
You'll never change. Always so shy.
Well, that's me. Anyway, I think I'll have the chicken Caesar salad. What are you going to have?
The salad sounds good. But I'm going to have soup, too, because I'm really hungry.
Focused Listening, page 82. As You Listen, part B. Listen again, but this time, read the conversation as you listen.
Oh, it's so nice to eat out and have time together. What a great birthday present.
I'm glad you like it. I'm always happy to treat you to lunch. And I was thinking, you know, we never really have time to just sit and talk.
I know. And now we have 2 hours. And this is a really nice place.
Yeah, I come here once in a while.
So, what are you going to have?
I'm not sure yet. But you order whatever you want. It's your birthday.
Whatever I want? Okay. But please, don't sing happy birthday when we have dessert. If you do, I'll go under the table.
You'll never change. Always so shy.
Well, that's me. Anyway, I think I'll have the chicken Caesar salad. What are you going to have?
The salad sounds good. But I'm going to have soup, too, because I'm really hungry.
Your turn. Listening challenge. Page 87. Listen to speaker A. Choose the best response for speaker B. A, B, or C.
1. Where do you want to have lunch?
2. When do you want to study for the test?
3. Do you want me to bring dessert or salad to your party?
4. When do you want to go to the city?
5. Where do you want to sit?
1. Mini Dialogues. Page 91. Listen to the mini dialogues. Repeat what you hear. Part 1.
1. Are you ready to order?
Not yet. We need another minute.
2. How often do you eat here?
Once in a while. 3. It's my treat.
Oh, no, thank you. But I'll pay half.
4. Where do you want to eat?
Wherever you want.
5. Let's go out to eat.
Great idea.
6. Can I get you anything else?
No, thanks. I'm fine for now.
Seven. When do you want to leave?
Whenever you want.
Part 2. 1. What are you going to have?
I'm not very hungry. I think I'll just have a cup of soup.
Some more coffee?
No, thanks. I'm fine.
Three. We ate outside last night.
Was it cold?
Four. We ate out last night.
Where did you go?
Why don't you ask for some water?
Six. Will that be all?
Yes, that's all.
Seven. Dad, what kind of drink can I get?
Whatever you want.
Exercise 4. Listen and write the expressions. Page 93. As you listen, fill in the blanks with the expressions that you hear. When you finish, perform the conversation with two classmates.
Now I can thank you. You know I love to eat out. And this is a great birthday present.
Well, I'm just glad to treat you and have time to sit and talk with you. Life these days is so busy.
Hi, can I take your order?
I'm sorry, we need a few more minutes.
No problem, I'll come back.
So, what are you going to have?
I don't know. But I want you to order whatever you want.
I have to tell you, I am very hungry.
That's okay. It's your birthday, and you can have anything. I think I'd like the fish special. It sounds really good.
You know, I think I'll have the same thing.
Where's the waiter? Oh. There he is. Excuse me, we're ready to order.
What would you like?
I'll have the fish special.
With soup or salad?
Salad. With oil and vinegar on the side, please.
And how about you?
I'll have the same.
Okay, that's two fish specials and two salads with oil and vinegar on the side. Will that be all?
Yes, that's all for now. Thanks.
Exercise 6. Dictation. Page 94. You will hear the dictation 3 times. First, just listen. Second, as you listen, write the dictation on a piece of paper. Skip lines. Third, check what you wrote.
Are you ready to order?
Yes. What kind of soup do you have?
Today, we have really good chicken soup.
That sounds good. I'd like a cup of soup and a turkey sandwich.
Would you like anything to drink?
Yes. I think I'll have some hot tea.
Will that be all?
Yes, for now. Thanks.
Are you ready to order? Question mark.
Yes. Period. What kind of suit do you have? Question mark.
Today, we have really good chicken soup. Period.
That sounds good. Period. I'd like a cup of soup and a turkey sandwich. Period.
Would you like anything to drink? Question mark.
Yes, comma. I think I'll have some hot tea. Period.
Will that be all? Question mark.
Yes, comma, for now, period. Thanks, period.
Are you ready to order?
Yes. What kind of soup do you have?
Today, we have really good chicken soup.
That sounds good. I'd like a cup of soup and a turkey sandwich.
Would you like anything to drink?
Yes. I think I'll have some hot tea.
Will that be all?
Yes, for now. Thanks.
End of CD 1. CD 2. All Clear 1. Listening and Speaking Audio Program. By Helen Kolbstein Fragiadakis. Copyright 2007. Published by Thompson Heinle, a part of the Thompson Corporation. All rights reserved. Lesson 6. Focused Listening. Page 100. As You Listen. Part A. Close your book. Listen to the conversation between Mike and Judy to find the answers to these questions. Why did Mike fall down? What is Judy going to do?
Ow, my leg is killing me.
What happened?
I was coming down the stairs too fast, and I fell down.
Do you think your leg is broken?
I don't know, but it hurts a lot.
Maybe you need to go to the emergency room.
No, let's wait a few minutes and see if it gets better.
Okay, but can I get you anything?
Maybe some ice.
Okay, I'll be right back. Okay, here. Can you move your leg?
I think so. But look, it's getting swollen.
Listen, Mike. I'm calling an ambulance right away. Stay put and don't move.
Focused listening, page 100. As you listen, part B. Listen again, but this time read the conversation as you listen.
Ow, my leg is killing me.
What happened?
I was coming down the stairs too fast and I fell down.
Do you think your leg is broken?
I don't know, but it hurts a lot.
Maybe you need to go to the emergency room.
No, let's wait a few minutes and see if it gets better.
Okay, but can I get you anything?
Maybe some ice.
Okay, I'll be right back. Okay, here. Can you move your leg?
I think so, but look, it's getting swollen.
Listen, Mike. I'm calling an ambulance right away. Stay put and don't move.
Your turn. Listening challenge. Page 107. Listen to the man complain. He has a lot of problems. Tell him what to do to feel better.
1. My head hurts. 2. My stomach hurts. 3. My tooth hurts. 4. My back hurts. 5. My ear hurts.
1. Mini dialogues. Page 110. Listen to the mini dialogues. Repeat what you hear. Part 1.
1.
Mama, I fell down. Ah.
Come over here and let me look at your knee.
Are you going anywhere this weekend?
Nope. We're going to stay put and relax at home.
3. Oh, my back is killing me.
Maybe you're working at your computer too much.
4. Are Judy and Mike married?
I think so, but I'm not sure.
5. What happened to Mike?
He fell down the stairs and broke his leg.
6. Hi, Judy. What's happening?
Not much. Just the same old routine.
2.
1. Where are you going? We have to leave right away.
I'll be right back. Don't worry.
Is getting swollen.
You're right. Do you think you broke it?
3. My favorite cup fell off the table and broke.
I'll get you another one.
crutches.
I broke my leg.
Get married?
No, I don't think so.
Exercise 4. Listen and write the expressions. Page 112. The following is a conversation between Mike, Judy, and a doctor. They are at a hospital emergency room. As you listen, fill in the blanks with the expressions that you hear. When you finish, perform the conversation with two classmates.
Hi, I'm Dr. Green. What can I do for you today?
My leg is killing me. I think I broke it.
What happened?
I fell down the stairs. I was reading something and I wasn't paying attention.
That's how these things happen. Here, let me take a look. Well, your leg is swollen.
And I put ice on it.
You need to get an x-ray right away. Wait here a moment and I'll be back. Excuse me, what's your name?
Judy.
Okay, Judy. Take Mike down the hall to room 212 for his x-ray. Then go back to the waiting room and I'll call you.
Thanks, Dr. Green. Do you think his leg's broken?
I think so, but I want to be sure.
Okay. Thanks, Doctor. Let's go, Mike.
Exercise 6. Dictation. Page 113. You will hear the dictation 3 times. First, just listen. Second, as you listen, write the dictation on a piece of paper. Skip lines. Third, check what you wrote.
Mike is standing at the top of the stairs. He is reading something. Then he falls down the stairs. His leg hurts a lot. He tells his wife Judy that his leg is killing him. Judy gets ice for him, and then she takes him to the hospital. The doctor says that Mike's leg is broken. Mike isn't happy because he has to stay put. He can't go to work for a few days. Mike is standing at the top of the stairs, period. He is reading something, period. Then he falls down the stairs, period. His leg hurts a lot, period. He tells his wife Judy that his leg is killing him, period. Judy gets ice for him and then she takes him to the hospital, period. The doctor says that Mike's leg is broken, period. Mike isn't happy because he has to stay put, period. Can't go to work for a few days, period.
Mike is standing at the top of the stairs. He is reading something. Then he falls down the stairs. His leg hurts a lot. He tells his wife, Judy, that his leg is killing him. Judy gets ice for him, and then she takes him to the hospital. The doctor says that Mike's leg is broken. Mike isn't happy because he has to stay put. He can't go to work for a few days.
Lesson 7, Focused Listening, page 120. As you listen, part A, close your book. Listen to the conversation in the store to find the answers to these questions. What do Lynn and Jim ask the salesperson? Does Jim buy a pair of jeans?
Can I help you?
Thanks. We're just looking.
Well, let me know if there's anything I can do for you.
What do you think of these jeans?
They're really nice. How much are they?
There's no price tag. Where's the salesperson? I'm going to ask her. Oh, there she is. Excuse me, how much are these jeans?
I'll be with you in a minute. Okay, let's see. They were $29, but I think today they're 30% off. Yes, that's right. They're about $20. That's a good price for these jeans.
Can I try them on?
Sure. The fitting rooms are right over there. Just go on in.
Thanks a lot.
Psst. Lynn, how do they look?
Oh, Jim, they're too big. I'll get you a smaller size. Wait a minute. Here, try these.
Thanks. Yeah, I think these are better. How do they look?
They're perfect.
Oh, they look very nice on you.
Great. I'll take them.
Focused Listening, page 120. As you listen, part B. Listen again, but this time read the conversation as you listen.
Can I help you?
Thanks. We're just looking.
Well, let me know if there's anything I can do for you.
What do you think of these jeans?
They're really nice. How much are they?
There's no price tag. Where's the salesperson? I'm going to ask her. Oh, there she is. Excuse me, how much are these jeans?
I'll be with you in a minute. Okay, let's see. They were $29, but I think today they're 30% off. Yes, that's right. They're about $20. That's a good price for these jeans.
Can I try them on?
Sure. The fitting rooms are right over there. Just go on in.
Thanks a lot.
Psst. Lynn, how do they look?
Oh, Jim, they're too big. I'll get you a smaller size. Wait a minute. Here, try these.
Thanks. Yeah, I think these are better. How do they look?
They're perfect.
Oh, they look very nice on you.
Great. I'll take them.
Your turn. Listening Challenge. Page 124. Listen to the sentences. Add to what each person is saying. Fill in the blanks with it or them. 1.
This is a nice suit.
2.
Those look like warm gloves.
3.
This shirt is too small.
4.
I love your hat.
shorts are okay.
Exercise 1. Mini dialogues. Page 128. Listen to the mini dialogues. Repeat what you hear. 1.
Can I help you?
Thanks. I'm just looking. 2. What do you think of this suit?
It's nice, but how much is it?
3. Excuse me, where can I try this on?
Over there, in the fitting rooms.
4. Are those new jeans?
Uh-huh. How do they look?
5. These are great sunglasses.
Yeah, but how much are they?
6. That's a great watch.
Yeah, but how much is it?
7. Can you come over tonight?
I'm not sure. Can I let you know later?
8. Hi, are you busy?
No. Come on in.
4. Listen and write the expressions. Page 130. The following is a conversation between Lynn, Jim, and a salesperson. Lynn and Jim finished shopping for jeans, and now they are shopping for a wedding gown for Lynn. A wedding gown is a special dress for a woman who is getting married. As you listen, fill in the blanks with the expressions that you hear. When you finish, perform the conversation with 2 classmates.
Hello. How are you 2 today?
Fine, thanks.
Can I help you find a wedding gown?
Thanks, but we're just looking right now.
No problem. Let me know if I can help.
Thanks. Lynn, look at this one. What do you think of this?
It's beautiful. How much is it?
It's too expensive.
Come on. Tell me how much.
200.
Excuse me. Can I try this on?
Sure. The fitting rooms are right over there. Just go on in.
Thanks. Jim? I'm ready. How does this look?
Wow. You look fantastic.
Yes, it looks beautiful on you.
We'll take it. But Jim, please don't wear your new jeans to our wedding.
Exercise 6, dictation, page 131. You will hear the dictation 3 times. First, just listen. Second, as you listen, write the dictation on a piece of paper. Skip lines. Third, check what you wrote. Lynn and Jim go shopping together for jeans. Jim asks Lynn, "What do you think of these jeans?" She likes them, but she asks, "How much are they?" They are about $20, and Jim tries them on. When Lynn sees Jim, she laughs because the jeans are very, very big. She gets a different size for Jim, and these jeans look very nice on him. Jim tells the salesperson, "I'll take them." Then they go shopping for a wedding gown for Lynn. They are going to get married very soon.
Jim. Go shopping together for jeans, period. Jim asks Lynn, comma, open quote, what do you think of these jeans? Question mark, closed quote. She likes them, comma. But she asks, comma, open quote, how much are they? Question mark, closed quote. They are about $20, and Jim tries them on, period. When Lynn sees Jim, comma, she laughs because the jeans are very, comma, very big, period. She gets a different size for Jim, and these jeans look very nice on him, period. Jim tells the salesperson, comma, open quote, I'll take them, period, closed quote. Then they go shopping for a wedding gown for Lynn, period. They are going to get married very soon, period. Lynn and Jim go shopping together for jeans. Jim asks Lynn, what do you think of these jeans? She likes them, but she asks, how much are they? They are about $20, and Jim tries them on. When Lynn sees Jim, she laughs because the jeans are very, very big. She gets a different size for Jim, and these jeans look very nice on him. Jim tells the salesperson, I'll take them. Then they go shopping for a wedding gown for Lynn. They are going to get married very soon. Lesson 8. Focused Listening. Page 138. As you listen. Part A. Close your book. Listen to the conversation between the husband and wife to find the answers to these questions. Why is she late? Who took a nap?
Hello?
Honey, it's me.
Where are you?
At the station. I missed my train, so I'm going to be late.
Oh, that's too bad. Will you get back in time to pick up the kids?
I don't think so. Can you get them?
No problem.
Make sure they start their homework.
Don't worry. What time do you think you'll be home?
Probably in about an hour. How was your day?
Well, I worked for a few hours hours at the computer, and then I got sleepy, so I took a nap.
You took a nap? You're so lucky you work at home. I can't take a nap in the office, you know.
But I also did the laundry and the dishes. You can't do those things at the office.
Well, that's true. Hey, what's for dinner?
Chicken. It'll be ready when you get home.
I can't wait. I love your chicken.
And I love you. See you around 6:30?
I hope so. See ya.
Focused Listening, page 138. As You Listen, Part B. Listen again, but this time, read the conversation as you listen.
Hello?
Honey, it's me.
Where are you?
At the station. I missed my train, so I'm going to be late.
Oh, that's too bad. Will you get back in time to pick up the kids?
I don't think so. Can you get them?
No problem.
Make sure they start their homework.
Don't worry. What time do you think you'll be home?
Probably in about an hour. How was your day?
Well, I worked for a few hours at the computer, and then I got sleepy. So I took a nap.
You took a nap? You're so lucky you work at home. I can't take a nap in the office, you know.
But I also did the laundry and the dishes. You can't do those things at the office.
Well, that's true. Hey, what's for dinner?
Chicken. It'll be ready when you get home.
I can't wait. I love your chicken.
And I love you. See you around 6:30?
I hope so. See ya.
Your turn. Listening challenge. Page 146. Listen to the people talk about what they can't wait to do and what they can't wait for. Put a check next to the items that they talk about. 1.
My cousin just had a baby. I can't wait to see him.
2.
He's very tired. He can't wait for his vacation.
3.
The teacher gave a test yesterday. I can't wait to see my grade.
4.
Their concert is next week. I can't wait.
5.
I'm so hungry. I can't wait for dinner.
6.
The little girl can't wait for her father to come home. She wants to play with him.
1. Mini dialogues. Page 147. Listen to the mini dialogues. Repeat what you hear. Part 1.
1. I'm getting really sleepy.
Why don't you take a nap? 2. I hope you locked the door and closed the windows.
Don't worry. I made sure everything was okay before I left.
3. Why are you so tired?
I did the laundry and the dishes, and I cleaned the house and worked in the garden.
before. Does he like his new job?
I don't know. I hope so.
Five. His party is going to be great.
I know. I can't wait to go.
Six. Is she angry with you?
I hope not.
Part two.
One. Why are you in a hurry?
I need to get back in time to make dinner.
Two. What time do you think you'll get home tonight?
Probably around 9 o'clock. Three. Can you help me with my homework?
No problem. I'm happy to help you.
Four. Sorry I got back so late.
I know there was a lot of traffic. Please make sure you're on time for your appointment.
Don't worry, I'm never late.
Six. I'm sorry I won't be home in time for dinner.
We'll save you some food.
Exercise 4. Listen and write the expressions. Page 149.
That chicken was really good. I'm lucky that I married you. You're a great cook.
Thanks.
And it's great that you did the laundry and the dishes. Did you have time to do your work at the computer?
Not today. But tomorrow I'll work a lot. Can you get back in time to pick up the kids and make dinner tomorrow?
Sure, no problem. I'll try to get home early. I'll make sure I take an early train. What do you want for dinner?
How about your delicious spaghetti?
I can do that. And the kids can help me.
I can't wait. I can almost taste it now.
You know, it's only 8:30, but I'm getting sleepy. I had a busy day.
And you didn't take a nap like I did. Maybe it's a good idea to go to bed early tonight.
Yeah, but I want to watch some TV first. What's on?
Exercise 6. Dictation, page 150. You will hear the dictation 3 times. First, just listen. Second, as you listen, write the dictation on a piece of paper. Skip lines. Third, check what you wrote.
A woman is coming home late from work because she missed her train. She has a cell phone. So she calls her husband and tells him she is late. He will pick up the kids and have a chicken dinner ready when she gets home. The wife thinks her husband is lucky because he works at home and he can take naps when he gets sleepy. He says that he does the laundry and the dishes because he is home. They have an interesting life. A woman is coming home late from work because she missed her train, period.
She has a cell phone, comma. So she calls her husband and tells him she is late, period. He will pick up the kids and have a chicken dinner ready when she gets home, period. The wife thinks her husband is lucky because he works at home and he can take naps when he gets sleepy, period. He says that he does the laundry and the dishes because he is home, period. They have an interesting life, period. A woman is coming home late from work because she missed her train. She has a cell phone, so she calls her husband and tells him she is late. He will pick up the kids and have a chicken dinner ready when she gets home. The wife thinks her husband is lucky because he works at home and he can take naps when he gets sleepy. He says that he does the laundry and the dishes because he is home. They have an interesting life.
Pronunciation. Lesson 1, page 157, part 1, sentence stress. Listen and say each expression. Make the words to, be, of, at, and the less strong, weaker than the other words. Practice saying the first part of the introductory dialogue. Make the capitalized words stronger than the other words.
What's wrong, Eric? I'm really nervous. I'm always this way on the first day of school.
You're not the only one. It's hard for me too. I'm glad we're taking this class together.
Do you know anything about the teacher?
Uh-huh, a little. Someone told me she gives a lot of homework, and you have to talk a lot in class.
Pronunciation, Lesson 1, page 158, Part 2, Contractions. Listen and repeat.
1. What's wrong?
2. I'm glad we're taking this class.
3. You're not the only one.
4. It's hard for me too.
5. Don't worry.
6. It doesn't get better for me.
7. The teacher's here.
8. Let's talk after class.
Pronunciation, Lesson 2, page 159, Part 1. Stress in phrasal verbs. Listen and repeat.
Hold on a minute and I'll get Sarah.
Alex, when are you going to hang up?
Why don't I pick you up at 7?
My parents are calling me for dinner, and I have to get off.
Pronunciation, Lesson 2, page 159, Part 2, Contractions. Listen and repeat.
1. Who's this?
2. It's Alex. 3. It's for you.
4. I'll be right there. 5. I'm really sorry. 6. I can't make it on Saturday.
7. Why don't I pick you up?
Pronunciation, Lesson 3, page 161. Pronunciation and listening practice. Listen again to the conversation. Repeat after the speakers.
You know, we have a 3-day weekend next month. Do you want to go away?
That's a great idea. Where do you want to go?
To the beach.
The beach? In the winter?
We don't have to go swimming. We can take walks on the beach.
But what else can we do?
Oh, there are plenty of things to do. We can read, go to the movies. I need to relax, don't you?
I sure do. You're right. The beach is a good idea, and it won't be crowded. Do you think we need to make a reservation anywhere?
No, I don't think so. There are lots of places to stay, and they will be cheaper now than they are in the summer.
Pronunciation, Lesson 4, page 163. Practice. Listen again to the conversation. Repeat after the speakers.
Wake up, Tom. Don't you have to go to the airport?
Yeah, I'll get up in 5 minutes. I don't want to get out of bed. It's so early.
Well, I'm going back to sleep. I hope you won't miss your plane. Have a good trip.
Thanks. Oh, why did I go to bed so late last night? It's so hard to get up, and it's so cold and dark. But I need to get up now and take a shower. What time is it? 6 o'clock? Oh no, I'm late. I don't have time for a shower. I have to get dressed and get to the airport right away.
Pronunciation, Lesson 5, page 164, Stress and Intonation.
Oh, it's so nice to eat out and have time together. What a great birthday present.
I'm glad you like it. I'm always happy to treat you to lunch. And I was thinking, you know, we never really have time to just sit and talk.
And now we have 2 hours. And this is a really nice place.
Yeah. I come here once in a while.
What are you going to have?
I'm not sure yet, but you order whatever you want. It's your birthday.
Pronunciation, Lesson 6, Page 167. Pronunciation and listening practice. Listen to the introductory conversations in lessons 5 and 6, and pay attention to the intonation used in questions. Then, practice repeating these questions as you listen.
Oh, it's so nice to eat out and have time together. What a great birthday present.
I'm glad you like it. I'm always happy to treat you to lunch. And I was thinking, you know, we never really have time to just sit and talk.
I know. And now we have 2 hours. And this is a really nice place.
Yeah, I come here once in a while.
So, what are you going to have?
I'm not sure yet. But you order whatever you want. It's your birthday.
Whatever I want? Okay. But please don't sing happy birthday when we have dessert. If you do, I'll go under the table.
You'll never change. Always so shy.
Well, that's me. Anyway, I think I'll have the chicken Caesar salad. What are you going to have?
The salad sounds good. But I'm going to have soup, too, because I'm really hungry.
Can I help you?
Thanks. We're just looking.
Well, let me know if there's anything I can do for you.
What do you think of these jeans?
They're really nice. How much are they?
There's no price tag. Where's the salesperson? I'm going to ask her. Oh, there she is. Excuse me, how much are these jeans?
I'll be with you in a minute. Okay, let's see. They were $29, but I think today they're 30% off. Yes, that's right. They're about $20. That's a good price for these jeans.
Can I try them on?
Sure. The fitting rooms are right over there. Just go on in.
Thanks a lot. Psst. Lynn, how do they look?
Oh, Jim, they're too big. I'll get you a smaller size. Wait a minute. Here, try these.
Thanks. Yeah, I think these are better. How do they look?
They're perfect.
Oh, they look very nice on you.
Great. I'll take them.
Pronunciation, Lesson 7, page 168. Pronunciation and listening practice. Listen again to the introductory conversation. Repeat after the speakers.
Can I help you?
Thanks. We're just looking.
Well, let me know if there's anything I can do for you.
What do you think of these jeans?
They're really nice. How much are they?
There's no price tag. Where's the salesperson? I'm going to ask her. Oh, there she is. Excuse me, how much are these jeans?
I'll be with you in a minute. Okay, let's see. They were $29, but I think today they're 30% off. Yes, that's right. They're about $20. That's a good price for these jeans.
Can I try them on?
Sure. The fitting rooms are right over there. Just go on in.
Thanks a lot.
Psst. Lynn, how do they look?
Oh, Jim, they're too big. I'll get you a smaller size. Wait a minute. Here, try these.
Thanks. Yeah, I think these are better. How do they look?
They're perfect.
Oh, they look very nice on you.
Great. I'll take them.
Pronunciation, Lesson 8, page 169. Stress, intonation, and rhythm review. Listen and repeat the Lesson 8 introductory conversation in thought groups. The syllables and words with the most stress are in capital letters. Remember to use rising, falling intonation in statements and WH questions. Use rising intonation in yes-no questions.
Hello?
Honey, it's me.
Where are you?
At the station. I missed my train, so I'm going to be late.
Oh, that's too bad. Will you get back in time to pick up the kids?
I don't think so. Can you get them?
No problem.
Make sure they start their homework.
Don't worry. What time do you think you'll be home?
Probably in about an hour. How was your day?
Well, I worked for a few hours at the computer, and then I got sleepy, so I took a nap.
You took a nap? You're so lucky you work at home. I can't take a nap in the office, you know.
But I also did the laundry and the dishes. You can't do those things at the office.
Well, that's true. Hey, what's for dinner?
Chicken. It'll be ready when you get home.
I can't wait. I love your chicken.
And I love you. See you around 6:30?
I hope so. See ya. Thank you.